Let's summarize this lesson. Chi-squared tests can check for how well observed values fit the expected values for categorical data. In this case, we have some variable that's categorical, and there are different responses for that variable. In our first example, when we were helping Professor Rogers decide whether or not he should hire that guide mountaineering company, the variable was success. Our responses were successful versus unsuccessful. In that case, there were just two responses, but there can be as many as we need for a particular categorical variable. And in the case of goodness of fit, our expected values are what we guess for our null hypothesis. However, in the case of independence, our expected values are based on the results of our marginal totals. Let's just assign some random numbers here. We have an m by n contingency table, and let's say the total number of subjects in the sample was 100. We would expect that 15 out of 100 of our subjects would have response 1 of variable 2. Therefore, we would expect that same proportion to have response 1 of variable 1. If there were 30 total in response 1 of variable 1, then we would expect 15 out of 100 times 30 for this cell. And here's what we would expect for the other cells. If it's easier for you to remember, the expected values are the column totals times the row totals divided by the total total. And then for both goodness of fit and independence chi-squared tests, we calculate the chi-squared statistic by taking the sum of each squared difference between the observed and expected values divided by the expected value. Then we can use the chi-squared table to determine if our results are statistically significant. That's if we're doing it by hand. But usually we'll use software, and the important part is that you know how to interpret our results.